Should I learn Quark or InDesign?
Quark is so 90s, like chained wallets and Hard Rock Cafe shirts.
I've been in places where a chained wallet would save you the hassle of ID theft.
They can put scanners in the credit card machine at the gas pump. And that's assuming they don't get the data from malware or pinching email.
So Quark has been around a long time. Should I learn it today?
If you had asked me in 1995, I would have said yes. It had 95% market share back then.
What about today?
Quark is around 20% today, while Adobe InDesign is about 25%.
That's a heck of a market reversal. What should I learn now?
Quark Design is supposedly better in terms of simplicity, while Adobe InDesign has more features.
Adobe InDesign is getting more and more expensive, especially since they switched from the software installation to subscription model.
The high price of Quark relative to upstart Adobe is why Quark fell from grace in the first place.
What do you think I should use? Adobe, because you can import all those funny photos you made in Photoshop?
And you can use the Dreamweaver software for web design using the same text and images you made in InDesign.
Quark has had a few new additions lately.
They now offer iPad and ebook publishing, which Adobe PDF has supported for years.
Adobe PDF has security holes.
That's like when people brag that there were no iOS viruses, mainly because it was only 5% of the market share.
Why did Adobe win?
InDesign let you render colors as they'd look when they printed out. You could manipulate text the way you can in Microsoft today, altering size, font and layout as you'd like.
I heard InDesign worked with MS Excel and the Mac OS.
That was another reason Adobe was better, because it played well with others. Quark was arrogant and had to play catch-up as Adobe evolved to meet customer needs.
Then I need to know Adobe just to know what the major employers do.
At least until Adobe is replaced by something cheaper and just as good.